For the first time in history, the U.S. Navy and Boeing have demonstrated air-to-air refueling using unmanned aircraft. The interaction happened between Boeing-owned MQ-25 T1 test asset and U.S. Navy FA-18 Super Hornet. A U.S. Navy report stated, "During the flight, the receiver, Navy FA-18 Super Hornet, approached the Boeing-owned MQ-25 T1 test asset, conducted a formation evaluation, wake survey, drogue tracking, and then plugged in with the unmanned aircraft. T1 then successfully transferred fuel from its aerial refueling store to the FA-18. The test had the MQ-25 originate at MidAmerica Airport in Mascoutah, Illinois, and the FA-18 was from the Air Test and Evaluation Squadron VX-23, which is based at Naval Air Station Patuxent River, Maryland. The drill lasted about 4.5 hours, and the two aircraft were connected for dry or wet connects numerous times for a total time of more than 10 minutes, with a total of 325 pounds of fuel passed. Well, on the face of it, this looks like relatively low-key development, it has a larger implication. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how MQ-25 Stingray unmanned tanker will take a bite off from Chinese DF-26 carrier killer missiles. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. American supercarriers are the face of the U.S. Navy and have allowed powered projection far away from the homeland. Nimitz-class carriers, which form the backbone of the U.S. carrier fleet, as well as the new Ford-class carriers, are the biggest warships to roam the oceans, displacing around 100,000 tons of water. The U.S. is the only nation to operate so many supercarriers, since they are very costly to build and operate. Due to technical and economic constraints, there are currently only a few countries with aircraft carriers, let alone having so many of these nuclear-powered mammoth supercarriers. Rivals know they can't match American supercarriers in quality and quantity, hence they're trying to develop asymmetric weapons to counter them. China has come up with a weapon specifically to address this threat, the DF-26 ballistic missile. The DF-26 has a range of 4,000 kilometers or 2,500 miles and is thought to be designed to conduct precision nuclear or conventional strikes against ground and naval targets. This missile is deemed to have an accuracy of 100 meters CEP. The missile was officially revealed at the Chinese 2015 parade commemorating the end of the Second World War. In April 2018, it was officially confirmed that the DF-26 was in service with the People's Liberation Army Rocket Force. As per reports, China currently has at least 16 launchers for this missile. Just a few days ago, China's state-run Global Times said that the Chinese People's Liberation Army (PLA) Rocket Force conducted a series of exercises with the aircraft carrier killer DF-26 ballistic missile at night. Boeing Boeing MQ-25 Stingray is an aerial refueling drone that resulted from the carrier-based aerial refueling system, CBARS, program. In October 2017, U.S. Navy released the final MQ-25 Stingray RFP. The competitors were Lockheed Martin, Boeing, Northrop Grumman, and General Atomics. General Atomics proposed the Sea Avenger concept, which is an enlarged version of the Avenger drone customized for air refueling. Lockheed Martin put on the table their Sea Ghost design based on the RQ-170 Sentinel. Northrop Grumman initially proposed X-47B, but later withdrew, stating it wouldn't be able to execute the program under the terms of the service's request for proposals. Boeing came into the competition with a full-fledged prototype derived from its Phantom Ray demonstrator, which ultimately won. The design is powered by a single Rolls-Royce AE-3007N turbofan engine that delivers 10,000 pounds or 4,500 kilograms of thrust. The initial contract of $805 million covers the design, development, fabrication, test, and delivery of four Stingray unmanned tanker drones. Ultimately, the contract is worth $13 billion, as around 72 such drones will be inducted in total. An F-A-18 or F-35 operates with a combat radius of 300 nautical miles, or 555 kilometers or 345 miles. An American supercarrier might need to operate within striking range of a DF-26 missile in order to project power and launch attacks over land. But with MQ-25 Stingray, this changes since the aircraft can be launched from further away. It's to be noted that F-A-18 can be armed with long-range precision weapons like AGM-158 Joint Air-to-Surface Standoff Missile, or JASSM, and JASSM-ER. It's a stealthy and highly precise surface-skimming cruise missile with a range of 230 miles or 370 kilometers and uses an inertial and GPS navigation system. AGM-158B JASSM-ER is the extended range variant of AGM-158 JASSM with a range of 925 plus kilometers or 575 plus miles. Not only would a carrier-launched drone remove the need for a large, non-stealthy, fixed-winged manned tanker to conduct operations in high-threat areas, but a drone refueling would enable the fighter jet to be present in the target's vicinity for a much longer time. To mitigate the challenge posed by DF-26, the U.S. military has already taken some steps. The Pentagon has awarded a $42 million contract to build a standoff weapons complex in Guam. Standoff missiles launched preemptively from Guam could be used to neutralize DF-26 ballistic missile launchers located on the Chinese mainland. Also, the U.S. carrier groups have warships armed with the SM-6 missile. The missile's capability enables it to shoot down a ballistic missile like DF-26 in its terminal phase. With the emergence of the MQ-25 Stingray, U.S. military planners will have added options. It's to be noted that only one component of the kill chain will need to be disrupted to put off the DF-26.